working to the name of God. But it's the name of Jesus that will last and stand forever. And God, we stand and we declare the word of God. We come against self in Jesus' name. God, let not Deta be seen. God, let not Deta be heard. But God, lift up the name of Jesus. For you said if you be lifted up, you will draw all men unto yourself. So God, in the name of Jesus, would you do a work in the name of Jesus? Would your mighty name be exalted? Thank you for it in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I bless you for it. I covenant to give you the praise. I covenant to give you the glory. For your name and your name alone is to be praised. Ah, come on and bless the Lord with me. Ah, come on, you better bless the Lord with me. Ah, glory be to the name of Jesus. This evening, just for a brief time, I want to share something the Lord placed on my heart. Glory be to the name of Jesus. A couple of weeks or last week, I heard somebody on the radio, a popular host, a radio host saying that she doesn't like to hear Christians talking about hell, and she gets scared when she hears the church talking about brimstone and fire and so forth. And I said to myself, woman, you don't gotta be afraid when you hear it. Glory be to God. As long as you name the name of Jesus, there's no reason for you to be afraid when you hear some messages on hell. My God, and so this evening, my God, Glintons and all of you under the sound of my voice, I came to let you know, glory be to the name of God, that it is more than just a reality show. I'm here to let you know, glory be to the name of God, that hell is more than just a reality show. My God, from Zion, from the scripture read, we find where the scripture opens up, my God, and we see where there are two men. I'm talking about a reality show. I know glory to God is so common now, it's popular now. I remember when I was a child growing up, we would watch Three's Company and we would watch all these other sitcoms. But now that it's so common, you turn it on and you watch American Idol and Swapping Wives. There are all these reality shows going on. And so, but I want you to know tonight, glory be to the name of God, that hell is more than just a reality show. Because when the scripture opens up, we find where, glory be to the name of God, where we see that there's a rich man. The Bible says that he fed sumptuously. My God, he must have been a big, big, big man. In addition to that, the Bible said he dressed well and he lived well. But my God, in the same yard or in the front of his gate, there was a man by the name of Lazarus. Lazarus didn't have the same that he had. But what my Bible tells me, because we're able to look into their lives now and we're able to see what's going on in their lives, what my Bible tells me was when Lazarus died, the Bible says that angels came and took him away. My God, from Zion. But glory be to the name of God. It also says that when the rich man died, oh, glory be to the name of God, he died. That's it, what he said. Oh, but when we look again, we see where the word of God says he opened his eyes in hell. Oh, glory to the name of God. When he opened his eyes in hell, my God, for The reality is the fact that when you die without Christ, that eternity will just begin for you. Hell is real. Stories and books have been written about near-death experiences. Where people have died and after having been resuscitated, they talk about how hell is real and Shoto. He said once we warn the people, their blood he will not require on our hands. So we're here to let you know, Glinton, that God says it's time for you to get right with him. Oh, come on, glory be to the name of Jesus. The Bible tells us, when we look in the Old Testament, we find there where it was common for there to be watchmen on the wall. Oh, come on, in Jerusalem, and they would have the watchmen all on the wall to see when enemy is coming. And then they would have to run and tell whomever that, hey, there's an attack coming. There are people coming from the east. There are people coming from the west. There are people coming from the north. There are people coming from the south. And the city had to get ready. Now, if they choose to ignore the warning, the city would be destroyed. Glinton's, we've come into your community. Oh, we've come as watchmen on the wall tonight. We've come to let you know, repent and be born again. We've come to let you know that now is the day of salvation. The Bible said, if you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Oh, glory be to the name of Jesus. Oh, you ought to know tonight that hell is real, Clinton. You ought to know tonight that it's more real than your child or whatever else you have around you. It's more real than that. And the Bible says that hell has enlarged in itself. You can't satisfy hell. Hell get the more hell warned. Don't let hell swallow you up. The Bible said hell enlarges itself. What are you going to say to God? What are you going to say to God on the day of judgment? Are you going to be one of those persons who's standing outside the portal tonight? Are you going to be one of those persons who said, wait, I'm right here? You're going to hear it's too late. The Bible tells us of some foolish virgins. Wise ones were ready to meet the bridegroom or the groom. They were ready. They had their lamps trimmed and they had extra oil. But there were five foolish ones who decided they ain't going to get no extra oil. They decided we gonna sleep and we gonna burn the oil and we gonna do whatever, we gonna party. And the groom came. And they weren't ready to meet him. And the door was closed on them. real. And unless you repent and be born again, you will realize that it's too late. You will be like those persons knocking on the door or on Art's door or North's door saying, let me in. Come on, you know, Noah built the ark for years and years and years. The Bible says that he built it for 120 years, and during that time he told the people, repent. They laughed at him, you fool, you senile old man. Just like you're probably thinking about us foolish Christians sitting on the end of time. Oh, but when we would have preached the word of God to you, our hearts would be clean. And you will have to give an account for the word that you would have heard. Oh, come on, don't be like the people knocking on the door. After Noah had built the ark, the Bible says that God locked the door. Because Noah could have decided he could be a little compassionate and let some people in. But listen here, unless your heart has been washed in the blood, there is no escaping hell. There is no escape other than the cross. There is no escape, Glinton. You must be born again. That's as simple as it is. And like I said, I don't come to you with no deep, profound speech. I come with the simplicity of the word of God. Be born again. Repent. I heard one of my mentors said like this. She said, if you believe that there is no hell, and I believe that there is a hell, and we come to the end of our lives, and it turns out that you were wrong and I was right, who would be in the better position? Oh, come on, you don't want to be at the end of your life and realize that you were wrong and realize that hell is a real place. Oh, you want to be born again. The Bible says that the rich man asked that someone would be sent to his brothers. Brothers, grandmothers, grandfathers, aunts, uncle, you are the brothers tonight. You are the one that rich man is saying, please send somebody to them. Please tell them that this place is real, and please tell them don't come here. Glinton, your word tonight is hell is real. It is real. And the enemy would like to keep you blinded, your minds blinded, so that you do not come to the knowledge of the truth. But I come against that in the name of Jesus. I bind up the powers of darkness right now. I come against the plans of the enemy in the name of Jesus. To hinder the word from taking root in your heart. I bind it up. God, let the will of God be done. For your word is good and it's quick and it's powerful. And I am so grateful, Lord God, that I don't even have to see them to know you're doing the work. I don't even have to see them to know, God, that your word is working in their heart. Our responsibility, Glinton, is to preach the gospel. And we have come and we have preached. Glory be to the name of God. And the word shall not return unto him void. You ought to repent. You are listening to us tonight. You don't know him in the pardon of your want you to have a relationship with the man called Jesus. You are listening to us tonight. You're not born again. Now is the day of salvation for you. Glinton, you don't know what your tomorrow holds. Don't be like the man who said, not now, tomorrow. Not now. When I get 25, I'll accept the Lord. You don't know what your tomorrow holds. Why play with your one soul, Glinton? Why are you going to play with the one soul that you have? I heard someone say it's like playing Russian roulette. One soul, one bullet. You ought to repent. Right where you are. The Bible says if we confess with our mouths and believe in our hearts that God had raised Christ from the dead, he said we shall be saved. You are listening to me tonight. You are listening and you know without a shadow of doubt that if Jesus was to come tonight, you would be lost in a Christless hell. You ought to repeat this prayer after me, because I am telling you tonight, to die is only gain if you have been washed in the blood of Jesus. You do not want to die without Christ. I want you to repeat after me, Lord Jesus. I am a sinner. I don't want to go to hell. And so I ask that you would come into my heart. Wash me in the blood of Jesus. By faith, I call you Father. By faith, I declare that I am your child. By faith, I exchange my sinful self for your righteousness. In Jesus' name, amen. You just prayed that prayer, Glinton, and all of you under the sound of my voice, you just prayed that prayer. The Bible says that the just shall live by faith. There was no thunderbolt, no lightning. Your bed didn't shake. But it's an act of faith. You made that decision tonight. God loves you, Glinton. He loves you, loves you, loves you. Allow the Lord to continue the work that he has started. Father God, in the name of Jesus, what an honor and a privilege to be able to declare the name of the Lord in the midst of the people. And even now, God, I am grateful that your word never returns unto you void. I am grateful, Lord God, for the souls that have come into the kingdom this night. I thank you, Lord God, that they not only come into the kingdom tonight, but they will grow and be, oh God, our soldiers in your army. Father God, that they will do exploits in the kingdom. Father God, you who started the work is more than able to complete it. And we bless you for it tonight. We honor you and we give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen.